Hey, it's your friends at Sling Support again. So you've just brought home a Slingbox. Great, let's get it set up together. Along with this video, the Slingbox offers lots of ways to help get you set up and running fast. For example, there's a quick start guide in the box. It shows how to hook up the cables and power. Also, the setup program that you'll be using in a bit features help links on every page for help and more info. We'll get to that in just a sec. Okay, let's open up the box. First up, here's the Slingbox itself and its unique power adapter. Next, this is the component video set. Notice that it's got green, blue, and red connectors. There's also a stereo audio cable set with red and white connectors. Finally, there's an external infrared, or IR, blaster cable. The Slingbox enclosure has a built-in remote control beam that controls your set-top box. This cable's only needed if the built-in remote control beam can't reach your set-top box. Let's begin the cable hookup by taking a look at the back of the set-top box. You'll take the included component video cable set and connect it to the video out connections on your set-top box. Now, you will likely find that you have some component cables connected here already, and they're probably going to your television set. If so, just disconnect them from the back of the set-top box and plug in the new cables that came with your Slingbox in their place. Just set the cables that are plugged into your TV set aside. We'll be using those in a bit. Now connect the other end of the new component cables to the video in jacks on the back of your Slingbox. You'll repeat the same process with the red and white audio cables. Just run them from the set-top box's audio out connections to the audio in connections on your Slingbox. Now we'll hook up your Slingbox to your TV. Do you remember the cables that we set aside earlier from your television set? Just plug those into the back of the Slingbox where it says video out. This allows the signal coming from your set-top box to pass through the Slingbox out to your television set. And you'll do the same thing for the red and white audio cable connections. And with that, all of the cables are hooked up. Just a quick note, you may not need to use the Slingbox as a pass-through to your TV. For instance, if you're using an HDMI cable to send the set-top box signal to your television. If that's the case, you can simply connect your set-top box component outputs to the Slingbox inputs and stop there. Now we'll connect the power adapter. You may have to rotate it a bit before it'll fit into the Slingbox socket. Plug the other end into a wall outlet and then give your Slingbox 2 minutes to power up fully. You'll know it's ready when the power light on the left is glowing steadily and the Sling logo light on the right is blinking on and off. You do have some choices when you set up your Slingbox. You can use your PC or your Mac with the free Sling Player for desktop software, or if you've purchased Sling Player software for your iPhone or iPad or Android phone, you can use those to configure your Slingbox too. The process is almost identical with each product, so for this video, we'll demonstrate using the free Sling Player for desktop software. You can download it from this web address, slingbox.com/setup. Once the file is downloaded to your computer, install it just like you would any other new software. One note, it's important to make sure that your computer or smartphone is connected to the same Wi-Fi network that you'd like your Slingbox connected to. Okay, let's fire up the software and log into your Sling account. And if you don't have a Sling account, you can create one here on the right side of the page. Next, you'll see the Slingbox directory and your Slingbox is listed here with a temporary name. Don't worry, we're going to rename that very soon. If you don't see your Slingbox here yet, just allow a couple of minutes from the time you plugged it in for it to appear. Click to begin setup. On the next screen, you'll have some choices for connecting the Slingbox to your home network. Let's focus on connecting via Wi-Fi. Click on that option to begin. When you configure your Slingbox via Wi-Fi, Sling Player temporarily disconnects your computer's Wi-Fi from your home network, and then reconnects it to the Wi-Fi access point built into the Slingbox. This lets you type your network name and password directly into the Slingbox. Once that's done, Sling Player reconnects your computer back to your home network automatically so you can continue with setup. Just be aware that while your computer or smartphone is disconnected from your home network, you can't really do things like surf the web or check email, but this disconnection is only for a minute or two. Now, if you're using Sling Player for iPhone or Sling Player for iPad, there is a slight extra step. Following the on-screen instructions, go to your iPad or iPhone's network app to manually switch its Wi-Fi connection over to the Slingbox. After doing that, just return to the Sling Player app to continue setup. Once you're back in the Sling Player app, the setup process is once again identical to the other versions of Sling Player. Next, choose your network from the list. Then type your network password. Remember, network passwords are case sensitive. If your network is hidden, like our example here, just choose Other Network, then type the network name, choose the network security type, and enter the network password. Click Continue. The Slingbox connects to your network, and then your computer's Wi-Fi reconnects you back to your home network, all automatically. Next up, we'll follow the on-screen directions to update the firmware inside the Slingbox. This may take a few minutes as it downloads and installs. Now let's personalize your Slingbox. First, give the Slingbox a name that you like. Next, you'll enter your country and postal code, and then click Continue. On the next screen, you'll select your TV service provider. Now select the make and model of your TV set-top box. It's important to get this right so that you can see the correct on-screen remote control. Probably the easiest way is to click Search, and then type a few letters of your set-top box's make and model. And don't worry about spaces and dashes here. Most set-top box listings pop right up. Click to select yours, and then continue on to the next screen. You should see an on-screen remote that looks just like the real thing. And if not, you can always go back and make sure that you pick the correct set-top box. Okay, the last steps. You'll let Sling Player check that the video is working correctly, and then you get to test your spiffy on-screen remote control. When your remote passes the test, you're done. Your new Slingbox is set up and ready to go. If you ever need to change any settings, you can always do that with either Sling Player for desktop or with the mobile versions of Sling Player that we mentioned earlier in this video. Now that your new Slingbox is all set up and ready to go, you can watch your TV programs wherever you are, whether you're at home or miles away. Be sure to check out our Sling support site for all kinds of useful stuff. You'll find helpful videos, informative articles, and links to follow us on Twitter, Facebook, or via our blog. You can also visit our user forum at community.sling.com for helpful discussions and answers to many questions. And be sure to subscribe to our YouTube channel at YouTube user Sling Support. Thanks for watching.